World War Z. World War Z. World War III. When the great bear is chewing on the three ribs of Daniel 7:5, then the bear hears the voice saying, "Hey, wake up! It's time to go eat all the flesh that you would like with their tanks and their buttons. And it'll stay in our head. Don't do it! Don't let it stay in your head. Wrong place for it to be, because we gotta let it go. Let go, let God." And so welcome, and it's time to let go. Be thankful for everything. Worry about nothing. And in all things, give thanks and high praises unto He who shall make a way where there seems to be no way. Because these tanks and these bombs and the horrors of man's inhumanity to man, this is evidence for this generation that we must get the bombs and the machine guns and the missiles and the atomic bombs out of our head. He is going to make a way where there has seemed to be no way, pulling down all strongholds, pulling down the mountains, lifting up the valleys, ripping the veil so that we can see love has always been behind it, if we will but beat our sword into the sickle of love for His harvest thereof. The fields are white as snow, and hearts are ready for the cranberries. Can you dig it? I hope you can, because the message behind the music is often wondrous. You know, the truth is, we live in the land of the walking dead. We have an aggressive mentality. We have an unkind mentality. I'm a preacher of love, hope, faith, and peace, and nobody likes me. I say that to the shame of everyone lazy in the spirit enough to not simply like a video, because the people that are listening to the sound of my voice, they know damn well that there has never been, nor shall there ever be, a more passionate preacher of faith, hope, peace, and faith. But do you think that I could get a $2 donation for anybody for my efforts? Do you think I could get anybody to like me? No, because these people got zombies in their head, and another head hangs lowly. It's time that we realize that the violence in this world is taking us to new places. Let silence now reign. Let us become mistaken. But you can see it's not me causing these issues. It's hearts that are hard. They are fighting. They're fighting with their tanks and their bombs. They are fighting with their guns in their head, in their head, in their head, over and over again. You cannot have peace until you get the war out of your head. And so it's time to quit being a zombie, a zombie, a zombie in our hearts. To be in the land of the walking dead, letting your love diminish so much that you just simply don't give a damn if passionate videos of love ever friggin' get out there. So don't like these videos. And the curse that will follow all people not liking these videos of love shall end up bringing them to the place where they shall find that they are a living zombie. And that is bad in this world. We need peace, love, and hope. So for all of those that won't let go of their bombs, you gotta know that another mother out there of somebody's brother is breaking down. Heart is taking them to a new level if they will but leave the violence in their head alone. to cause silence to come forth so that they can realize that they've been mistaken all along. It's always been the same. Everything is the same. There is nothing new under the sun. People are coming with their tanks and their bombs and their guns, and it's in their heart and it's in our heads if we dwell upon it. So it's time to leave the land of the walking dead, where our love has died and it's just become a noun, making us into a zombie. And so it's time to get the stuff out of our hearts. It starts there, the root thereof. Pull up the root. Quit being a zombie. Leave the land of the walking dead. For we were born with childlike love, with our love moving passionately. There was no bombs. There was no grunge and war and death in our heads when we were but young. And our love was alive, moving as a verb. So it's time for that to flare and flame on again. The living brightness of love to be our guide, to show us how to abandon our inner zombies and our inner dead people walking. Because if we will not back up, we will commit blasphemy of the Holy Spirit. And that ain't good. There is no solution from that one.